We'll be live. What's good, Jerry? Welcome to another Mortal Kombat reaction. And reacting to Mortal Kombat 1 Chaos Reign official Cyrax gameplay trailer. And it's the yellow one. Not the red one. The yellow one. The red one Sektor. Just so y'all know. I know you guys get confused, but the yellow one Sektor. But and then we, and not just the yellow one being Sektor. It is a gender swap. They have, those who may not know, they have made the decision to gender swap Cyrax and Sektor. Or hell, they didn't even go by just gender swapping one of them. They just decided we're going to gender swap both of them. And it's an interesting choice. Like I said, I wasn't like expecting that to be a change. I mean, I was like, you know, you do have a nice big roster of female characters. You could just use if you want more females. But neither here nor there. They decided to gender swap them, so they say, it is what it is. I mean, you know, Takeda's a cousin now. So Takeda's Kenshi's cousin instead of his son. Sektor and Cyrax are girls instead of boys. This whole new timeline, crazy, bro. So I guess Cassie gonna be either Sonya's sister or Sonya's cousin. What the freak happened? All right, y'all, I'm gonna waste some more time and see what Cyrax is giving us in this new Mortal Kombat 1 DLC, Chaos Reigns. Let's get it. And go. She looks cool though.
Where are you?
Over here.
So, basically, cinematic training.
Your full unseen attacking from a distance. There are rules.
We have found Quan Liang and his Shirai Ryu.
Man, grab it so good.
They gather at the Wuxi for his wedding.
Attack his wedding? We may win the battle, but find we lose the war. No one will respect us.
Better to be feared than respected.
See, she gonna be on our side. She gonna be on our side.
No, we are not doing the Red Wedding. Season 3, Episode 9.
I never watched it, but I know the rest. Okay. They do look cool, bro.
How long have we known each other that you could ever believe I...
You vanished without explanation. The hand my Grand Master gave me one.
You blame me for your actions?
Are you serious? Now maybe because I wasn't able to go back. You thought about that? If I went back, he would totally got everybody to freaking kill me, bro. That's cool. Dang. Ooh.
I was wrong thinking you worthy of that armor.
Ooh. So that's exactly what's happening.
You are my instructor and my commander.
Oh,
don't
okay.
Confuse that with being my superior.
I say, so she's gonna join us.
My speed and skill
spoiler
beyond yeah. You.
That's alright, so they already expected that to actually happen.
Finish him.
Ooh. Okay, I finished off down. Woohoo! God! Wow, I think that. Did she just rub her feet? Bro, that's disrespectful, bro. Take his head off and kick it back at him. Oh, and a bounce. Dang. Oh my god, bro. Hey. Man. That's crazy, bro. So, like I said, I kind of respect it. Like, Sektor, Cyrax was always the one that was kind of, I think she, he was more, you know, open-minded. Well, because they were both kind of like mind control, but he was more open-minded, I believe. But they both kind of went on our side, I think. And like, I think about like Mortal Kombat 11. I think they both, we woke them both up and they kind of was both on our side, right? I think that's what happened in 11. Because they're both heavily sideboard. So the unfortunate fate of Cyrax and Sektor that they returned to, you know, kind of like mind control robe cyborgs. And, you know, they were like, they were more machine than man. And they were never really right until, I guess, they fixed something in 11, you know, kind of got them back towards the end. So this one, gender swapped, but these ones don't are not, wasn't forced into a cybernetic change. These are armors that they're wearing. So they're wearing, you know, basically pretty much wearing like an Iron Man armor pretty much. So, hey, she looks cool. The armor looks cool. Hopefully the costume sets look cool. So I'm going to guess Sektor's truck going to be next. And my guess, because she's no part of this character, is a part of the story. So I'm guessing she will be next. We'll see her side of the story, you know. So kind of messed up. Well, it makes sense. So he's, instead of him just kind of, you know, he just basically lied. Because like I said, no. Because the thing is, no one knows that their fearless leader Sub-Zero, you know. Basically the reason their father, basically the original leader of the Lin Kuei is dead. Basically saying, had a chance to save him, chose not to. Which is one of the most craziest moments you ever hear in Mortal Kombat 1. That Sub-Zero had a chance to save his father, but realized how his father was running things, took the opportunity to let his father die. He didn't put a sword through him. He just backed up and was like, you know what? You know, Dad, I love you. You know what I'm saying? But I like how you run things. I'm going to run things my way. I'm not going to kill you. But I don't have to save you. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to tell people you died in battle. You know? That was heavily messed up. When you found that out. Like, wow. You piece of crap. So, looking forward to this. But because you might get saved. Him turning to new Cyborg in this DLC. If y'all hear stuff outside, that's like my neighbors getting something done over there. So you're going to hear a lot of stuff. So we find out he's going to turn into a new Cyborg in this DLC, which probably say deservingly, because he is a piece of crap. It's like, wow, you ain't no different. You just a-hole here, huh? Just like the first time. All right, y'all. That's it for this one. I'm looking forward to Mortal Kombat 1 Chaos. Like I said, I haven't played Mortal Kombat in a minute because really nothing to play. But I'm looking for this DLC. I'm always into more new stories. I'm here for it. I'll see you guys in the next Mortal Kombat reaction, which would probably be Sektor, I'm assuming. So see y'all then.